So I think neoadjuvant HER2-directed therapy is probably in flux right now. Since 2013, we've primarily been giving pertuzumab-based chemotherapy in the preoperative setting based on the results of Neosphere and Trifina. However, now we have data in the adjuvant setting looking at the long-term benefits of pertuzumab with affinity, suggesting that the benefit in terms of disease-free survival from the use of pertuzumab appears to be small, with a 1.7% absolute difference in outcomes from the addition of pertuzumab, where the primary benefit was really seen in the node-positive, hormone receptor-negative patients. And so I do think our approach in the neoadjuvant setting is likely to change, whereas we were standardly using pertuzumab-based chemotherapy for the majority of our tumors that were over 2 centimeters. I think that may not be necessary, since we now know that not all patients are going to gain long-term benefits from pertuzumab, and potentially we could consider altering our preoperative approach to using pertuzumab in patients who have high-risk tumors, so those tumors that we know are node-positive up front, or those tumors that are hormone receptor negative.